Hello, I'm Mary Gordon from Roots of Empathy, and I'd like to speak to you about the temperament trait of first reaction. And this really is about the degree of caution or adventure that a child approaches new things, whether it's new food or new clothes or new people or a new situation. And just as in all the other temperament traits, there is a continuum. So with first reaction, the low end of the continuum would be a child who's quite cautious. On the high end of the continuum is a child who's very adventurous. And neither is a good or bad. But for parenting, there are very strong implications for both of these if you're on the extreme. If we go through childhood with this lens of first reaction in mind, if you think about your babies, when they were little, some babies would refuse new foods. And other babies would welcome whatever you brought on, even spinach. So it's just to know very early that all children arrive predisposed to be somewhere along the first reaction continuum. You did not create it. So that if you have a very cautious baby, it's not your credit or your fault. It is. So if you then go ahead and you look at the toddler years. And little toddlers, their big thing is independence. So let's look at the high end, the adventurous end of the continuum. If you've got a very adventurous toddler, you are constantly looking out for their safety because they could be scaling the bookcase. Whereas if you have a toddler who is very low in first reaction, they might need coaxing to adventure outside the kitchen in their crawling. So it's really about finding the little person you have and helping them live in their skin and live in this world. So then if you look at the preschool age child, they are the kids on the high end are very adventurous. They get a lot of cuts and bruises. Many will break their bones. But if you look at the low end of the continuum, the very cautious children, they are the ones who will want to wear the same t-shirt every single day. Why? Because they know what to expect. They like the feel of it. They like the look of it. They feel at home in it. And the big thing is we ourselves are most at home and ourselves when we're in the house. Little children actually become who they are when they're at home. So let's allow them to be who they are. Let's then go to the school years. And if we look at the school years, there are many, many opportunities for children. And if you think even about starting kindergarten, if you had a very highly adventurous child, they could not wait to get in there. If you had a child who was very cautious, you probably had anxious nights where they weren't sleeping well or they reverted to bedwetting because the whole idea of this new experience was overwhelming. So our job as parents is always to read the little person we have the privilege of parenting and to help them cope. So then let's go to high school. So in high school, children really have more opportunities to be at credible risk, you know, because they're introduced to a whole range of things that are outside the family that you cannot control for, so that you just hope that of over all the years of parenting, you have had a chance to help them learn to trust themselves by respecting how they felt and encouraging them to take minimal risks and or maybe to tone down the risks they take. So in high school, the availability of drugs, of alcohol, of vehicles, of situations where they are outside of the home and there's huge peer pressure. If you have a child who's very low on the continuum and is very cautious, you would hope they have a friend who's a bit more adventurous because peers have more influence on many of the children's decisions in high school than do parents. The parents' impact is cumulative and certainly helps them deal with high school. And if you have a child who's very high on adventure, who would be prone to risk-taking, you just hope they have some friends who are more cautious to balance out what they do. So I think this whole idea of how does the world see children who are more cautious? In grade school, they're often called wimps, which is beyond cruel. And sometimes in grade school, children who are more adventurous will climb to the top of the climbing structure. They often are seen as heroes. And I think that is a reflection of the world. And in the home, we have the opportunity to encourage the children's natural exploration, the children's natural way of being. And it's interesting, you know, this idea of failing. Very often, children are afraid of failing. And little ones who might be more cautious might need encouragement to try and fail, because that's how we solve problems and get ahead in life. It's not so much an issue for the child who is very adventurous. They expect to fail. So there's no one right way to be. The children's roaming space when they're little has changed. It's shrunken. There are not as many safe places for them to go as there used to be. But all children need to take appropriate risks so that they can experience failure and experience success, their own definition of success. So this first reaction is really about honoring the reality of who your child arrives as and helping them deal with the world that is.